it goes to ولئن شكرتم لأزيدنكم. If you say الحمد لله I'll give you more and you give to the poor. It reminds us of a hadith, one of the stories that Rasul Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that there was a man walking and he heard somebody talking to a cloud and say, go and rain on so and so's farm. So he says, I followed the cloud and I seen it come to a certain place and start raining and then stopped. So he found somebody working in this farm. He asked him his name and he told him, my name is so and so. And that was the word that he heard for the clouds. So the man asked him, why do you ask? He says, I heard an order going to the cloud to rain on your farm. What do you do special? The man said, everything that I take out of my farm, I divide it into three parts. One part is for me and my family. One part I donate for the sake of Allah. I give to the poor. And the last part, I reinvest in it. And that's why I've been successful. This is great advice for all of us, inshallah. There's a lot more to come. Please stand by for the break. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and welcome back to Spirit of Islam. Today we are talking about some of the wonders and miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows us in the Quran. And as I mentioned earlier, I encourage you to go and read the Quran and reflect, read it with an open-minded, open heart and learn the wonders that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. And now we will go to the chapter of Yusuf, Surah Yusuf, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the scene. As we know, Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam was brought up in a rich family in Egypt, with a rich family in Egypt. And this scene describes that the wife of the rich man that were taking care of him was tempted by Prophet Yusuf because they say he was one of the most handsome men in the world. She was tempted by him. And this scene, in this ayah in the Quran says, وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا هَمَّتْ بِهِ, she went for him. And هَمَّ بِهَا, the scholars in Arabic disagreed. What does it mean? Some scholars say, no, he tried to push her away when she is so tempted and she wants him. And some scholars say, well, it was only assorted in his mind. And I say, we should not try to go in the mind of Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam. And if we see the prophets are role models, as a role model, he must have thought about this beautiful woman, he's offering herself to him. But what does the next part of the ayah say? لَوْلَا أَنْ رَأَى بُرْهَانَ رَبِّهُ. But he's seen a proof from Allah or a sign from Allah to stop. And he stopped right then and there. And he says, it is my God and he took care of me and I cannot do this wrong thing. And this is the important thing I'd like to focus on rather than say what was going on the mind of Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, which none of us could say. This is a beautiful lady. He's offering herself to this young man. And as a human being, if he's a role model, if he's a normal man, any man will think of this beautiful lady. But the challenge and the strength is he stopped right there and said, told her no, when he seen the sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is an important thing that I tell all young people. Anybody who tries to go and do something wrong, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends a sign to stop him. It's Allah's rule. Allah helps us to stop. You're going on to do something wrong and the car doesn't start. A lot of us will ask a friend for a ride or kind of try to take a cab. But the sign is saying, don't do it. And at this moment, we should stop and say, Alhamdulillah, that I seen the sign and I seen the proof. And as we know, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell us that there is seven groups that will be shaded in the Day of Judgment where there is no shade other than the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of this group, a man who was invited, or a woman, a wealthy, beautiful woman who offered herself to this man, and this man tells her, sorry, inni akhafu Allah, I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the strength, and this is what I read in this ayah, that Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam tells her, sorry, I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and stays away from her. And if we look at another ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the story of a very strong believer, he believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they say he was one of the few who memorized the Torah at that time. And then, you know, something went and he got disarrayed, and he got misguided. And it says here in the ayah, when we look at the ayah, فَانْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا, he had to pull himself away from the way of Allah. It's not easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not just leave us to stray. He gives us signs, he gives us things to stop us, he reminds us. And then when finally we insist on doing the bad thing, we stay, go away. So here, this ayah describes انْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا is like taking the wool of a sheep or a wool of an animal. You have to pull hard to get out. So this man was on the right track and he decided to get misguided. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the signs, gave him the things. And when he insisted, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left him. And what does it say in the Quran? فَاتَّبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانِ. The devil, a shaitan, is watching, seeing this good man, and would love to put his hand on him to make him disguided more. But because he was protected by Allah, the shaitan could not do anything. Once this man strayed, the shaitan was there watching for him and welcoming him to the wrong path. And here, what the important sign for us is, when we get a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we're doing something wrong, we should stop. We should not persist. We should obey and say سمعنا وأطعنا, we have heard and we have obeyed. And another example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran that all the creatures, everything that walks on this earth is a nation just like us. We are as human nation, but the birds and everything else is a nation. They have their communication skills, they have their things, and we have to learn. And I like this ayah in chapter Al-Ma'idah, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, where it describes the two children of Adam, the two sons of Adam, where one of them got jealous and he killed his brother. And as we know, this is the first crime committed by mankind. And he killed his brother, but they are new on earth and they don't understand, so he didn't know what to do, how to bury. So this ayah describes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the crow in front of this the son of Adam alayhi salam, and this crow was digging in earth to bury another dead crow. And the son of Adam watched and watched this crow digging and then putting the body of the other dead crow and then covering it, and he realized there was a message for him there, that we have to bury our dead. And he says a famous word, I say to myself, عَجَزْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِثْلَ هَذَا الْغُرَابِ. Was I disabled? Weren't I able to be like this crow? And he said to bury his brother, so he learned how to bury. But one of the lessons we learn here is he observed animals. He observed birds and knew there was a message. And this is what I encourage us all to look and look at the wonders of the birds. You know, we know that the ants has a kingdom and they work together to cooperate, and how they collect the food during the summer to keep it for the winter to survive, how they are a community. So here, or everything, or they are all nations and they work together, and there's so much to learn from them, rather than most of us, a lot of us are so busy going through life, so busy with our studies, with our work, with everything, that we disregard these messages, these lessons that's to be learned. So a lot of cases, I like to take my time, as they say, wake up and smell the coffee, or wake up and smell the trees. That's what we have to do in life. Enjoy ourselves, smell what's out there, and reflect on every animal, every bird, everything. And this is the thing we have to learn. And another example we learn, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in Surah An-Naml, in the chapter An-Naml, which is the ants, about when Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam was leading his army. And he heard, because as we know, Prophet Solomon could understood the languages of birds and insects and things, and he heard this ant talking to its community. It says, oh, you ants, go back into your holes so Suleiman and his soldier do not destroy you while they do not know. And if we reflect here, first of all, the ant is worried about every other ant. This ant doesn't go and hide and then calls upon them. As soon as she sees the danger, she's calling to all the ants, be careful, watch out. And this is for all of us humans. When we see a danger, rather than thinking of ourselves, we have to think of every other human out there and work with them. And the other thing is Sulaiman, Prophet Solomon, this great king and this great prophet, he stops the army for this ant. And he smiles and says, Alhamdulillah, that I had this ability. And we notice the ant says, this, Solomon and his soldier would not destroy you if knowingly. They would not. They didn't see you and they're busy on their way, so they destroy you. Solomon with the great army would stop to for the ants. And this is what we reflect and we have to say. We have to respect every creature on earth. That's what as Quran is teaching us. Respect every creature, big and small, because they are the creatures of Allah and they are nations just like us. They communicate and they work, and yes, they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.